your girl Yammy. I've escaped. I've escaped. Don't tell Boo. Shh. I'm out here at Hollywood Studios and I'm gonna go check it out. But I escaped. I couldn't be locked up another day. I'm like, please let me go. So here I am. Let's go have some fun.
Okay. Looks like our first trip is into the dark room. Look at, see what goodies we can possibly find in here.
Found a new little outfit here. I thought that was cute. It's just plain on the back, but look at the shirt that matches it. And blue on the back, but isn't that cute? Let me see, 25 for the shorts and the shirt is also 25, so $50. $50 for the outfit. Unless you're a pass holder, then you get 30% off. Shh, don't tell nobody. And then there's t-shirts there. And that t-shirt, that's new. All the stitch is new. Alright, I'm here at Hollywood Studios finding all the new stuff. Give me snacks. Yep, that's new. I don't remember these socks. They are cool. Aren't they fun looking? Look at that.
Oh boy.
Oh, here, here's another. Okay, now this one's a snack shorts. With a stitch eating snacks. All right, that one's cute. Yeah, that one's cute.
Okay, guys. Aprons. Sponges out. Those are pretty cool looking.
They're balloon Mickey.
Yeah.
They're scrubbies.
Scrubbies, scrubbies.
$6 for a scrubby.
And then look at the one to your right. It's a monorail.
Monorail.
Just a quick little overview of all the. It's like Christmas ornaments for your pleasure. Quite a bit to choose from, that's for sure. Here you go, guys. Still get a chance to get this Halloween candy. It's buy one, get one. You got your lights. And these are something different than I've seen before. Oh, no.
Wait,
guys, you know. There she is, Oogie Boogie. Oogie Boogie. Oogie Boogie. Oogie Boogie.
Mmm.
Look at this bag. This is nice. It lights up. I'm trying to get an idea of the crowds. From when you first come in, so I guess I don't know. I guess it's not too bad right now. But we haven't been over to Galaxy's Edge or Toy Story Land, the places that are usually where it's a little bit more crowded. Okay. Now as we take a look down Sunset Boulevard. Pretty much about the same. Crowds aren't too bad. Only thing that's bigger is the line that's to go into Starbucks. I think they're giving away something today. I think it's because it's Triple Star Day. I think Yammy's gonna be getting her drink today too from Starbucks.
Where are we going, Yammy?
We're gonna go see the Frozen sing along. Come on, hurry up.
Okay,
I want to go. I'm excited. We got to see if our people are there. Oh, and here are their show times. So we made it to the second show today. At the first one.
Check this out, guys. This is we're seeing Frozen Forever After now. Look how the seating is. You can. They definitely won't fill us out like they used to.
The safety of everyone. Please maintain physical distancing by sitting in designated rows only, and allow room between parties by leaving seats open. Thank you for your understanding and cooperation. Please enjoy the show.
Thank you. We will.
Showtime!
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Disney's Hollywood Studios welcomes you to, for the first time in forever, a Frozen sing-along celebration. Please feel free to sing along at the top of your lungs. Thank you.
I'm all excited. She's a new girl.
It's special because for the first time in, well, forever, Elsa and I will be celebrating the Arendelle Festival!
Yay!
I'm Anna, and now it's my great honor to introduce to you the Royal Historians of Arendelle!
Yay! Hi, I'm Gloria!
Hello! I am Sir Eric!
Knighted.
Knighted? What? Well, I mean, yeah, I've been going to night school.
Yes.
Thank you for the pity. Just Eric at your service.
thank you, Just Eric. And what better way to celebrate Arendelle than for the royal historians to share the story of our kingdom and our queen, who just happens to be my sister, Queen Elsa!
Queen Elsa! Where is she? Wait, what? I've been this for so long.
I don't know. What? Have any of you seen my sister? She's about so tall, blonde, mm-hmm. kind of keeps to herself. Oh, and she does have these weird, icy snow powers, like,
Thank you.
No, huh? Oh, I know. Hey, Elsa, do you want to build a snowman?
No, that never really works.
Yeah, that never really works.
Oh, never does.
I don't know. Well, what are we going to do? It's almost time for the Arendelle Festival. Well, and
I remember it.
And everyone's already here. Oh, this is almost as bad as that blizzard.
Anna.
Hey. Almost.
Hey, we got this. Oh. You go find your sister. Yeah. We'll share history in Arendelle.
Yeah, we'll have them sing all of the royal anthems. It'll be so fun.
Yeah, that sounds good. Well, I best be off to find my sister, but I'll be back. Elsa?
Are you ready?
I was born ready. Let's do this.
Citizens of the Kingdom of Hollywood Land, we proudly present to you the story of Anna and Elsa. We also cordially invite you to sing along to any of our Arendelle anthems. Just follow along if you don't know the words.
Aria, I have a feeling they already know the words.
Yes! Yeah. So where do we start?
Let it go! Let it go!
No, 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 no.
What were you thinking?
Where every good story starts at the beginning.
Beginning. Oh, I got this.
Okay.
It was a dark and stormy night.
No, it wasn't.
What?
It was a tale as old as time.
No, it wasn't that easy.
Okay, could you just tell me where it started?
It was a beautiful day in the kingdom of Arendelle.
Oh, that's right. Okay. Yeah. There were two sisters who loved each other very much.
Princess Elsa and Princess Anna.
But Princess Elsa was born with
special powers. Magical powers that created snow and ice. Anna loved playing in Elsa's magical snow.
Well, until one night something terrible happened. Elsa created a monster snowman.
Don't miss the part where Elsa hits Anna with her powers, freezing her head.
The king and queen rushed Anna to the trolls for help.
Now, if you've
never met a troll before, consider yourself lucky, because these are mischievous creatures with strange magic, and I am not a fan of them because they wouldn't let me join their band, their rock band, because they're rocks.
Focus!
Sorry.
Grandpappy, king of the trolls, speaks Anna and they have removed all memories of magic.
Listen to me, Elsa. Your power will only grow. There is beauty in it, but also great danger. You must learn to control it. Fear will be your enemy.
They decided to keep Elsa's powers hidden from Anna. And then the saddest thing happened.
No more snowmen?
No more snowmen!
Oh, get ready to sing along!
Elsa?
Hey guys, I'm really sorry. I'm not going to be able to play this song, and you're not going to be able to hear me singing because they won't let me publish it because it's copyrighted. So she's asking if you want to go build a snowman, and she says no. Okay, bye. My parents leave, you know, that kind of a thing. You know how it goes.
See you in 2 weeks. Do you have to go?
You'll be fine, Elsa.
Aria? What's going on here?
I'll explain it to you later.
Where'd the boat go?
I'll explain it to you later.
Fine, I mean, it's just scary. You know there could be sharks down there? I mean, even baby sharks? Do-do-do-do-do-do. When they die?
Well,
what? Dead parents? What is this? Bambi? Or Tarzan? Or the Lion King?
Hakuna Matata. Oh, it's very sad. What? It propelled Elsa toward her destiny in our story forward to the best day ever.
My birthday.
A coronation day.
Coronations are my favorite flower.
Yeah. Several years passed and it was time for Elsa to take the crown.
She stole the crown. 5-finger discount.
No, she didn't. Did you sleep through all of Arendelle History 101?
I mean, I slept through most of college, so yeah, that sounds about right.
True. Well, Elsa was to become Queen of Arendelle.
Well, wait, what about her snowy powers?
Oh, exactly. She was afraid her powers would show and she'd be cast out of the kingdom forever.
Forever. Ooh, and all the while, her sister Anna was dreaming of the drooling of the possibilities of opening the castle gates for the first time in...
forever!
You got it! Hey, Anna, what day is it?
It's Coronation Day!
Dark.
And dreamy!
Right.
Prince Hans of the Southern Isles!
Prince who of the Southern Isles? Oh, no, no, no. I do not like the look of this guy, and it looks like his horse has got a skunk on his head.
Don't be jealous because he's dreamy.
Well, you think Hans is dreamy? That's great. Well, you said that already, okay?
Well, I'm going to say that one more time because that guy is dreamy!
I am impressed and afraid.
Conceal, don't feel.
Hey, Aria. Conceal, don't feel.
Oh, I knew that one.
It's Coronation Day, remember? All the citizens of Arendelle and dignitaries from kingdoms all over, they came to witness the royal coronation.
Elsa was very nervous, but she was able to hide her powers long enough to be sworn in as queen. Queen of Arendelle.
Yes, Queen. Yeah. When they parted.
Oh, yeah. Ice, baby. Oh, and there was chocolate, the sister's favorite food.
Well, even chocolate couldn't make it less awkward between them. I mean, they never see each other anymore. But it seemed like maybe, just maybe, all of that was about to change.
Yeah, and then Hans came back, and they danced the night away.
Oh, yeah, he's so handsome.
Yeah, don't you just love true love?
I do love true love, but this is not true love. They just met each other.
Well, clearly you don't know anything about true love. What? As a wise woman once said, love is an open door.
A wise woman also said to wear your face coverings while you sing along.
I would never shame.
Okay, can I just say something crazy?
I mean, it's crazy. We finish each other's
sandwiches.
Can I say something crazy? Will you marry me?
Can I say something even crazier?
No!
Yes!
Oh. As Queen Elsa once said, and I quote, you can't marry a man you just met.
Well, as Princess Anna once said, and I quote, you can if it's true love.
Yeah, well, that is a loophole, and it didn't matter, because everything was about to change, and it had nothing to do with true love.
Yeah. Anna pushed Elsa too far, and she accidentally threw ice all over the ballroom.
Yeah, people call her a witch, a sorcerer. She impaled someone right in the spleen.
Oh, no, the spleen.
Wait, what?
It's on the bonus features. Oh. Yes, check it out.
Regardless, everyone was scared.
Well, but no one was more scared than Queen Elsa herself. I mean, despite Anna's pleading, she ran away across the fjord of Arendelle, freezing into the process.
She froze all of Arendelle, leaving our beautiful kingdom in a cold, dark curse.
Arya, it was beyond cold.
It was frozen!
Get ready to let it go!
But don't let go of your face cover!
For you, Dad. The cold never bothered me anyway.
Real good, because there's about to be a lot more snow. See, Anna, feeling like the whole thing was her fault.
Yes, it was.
She went out into the blizzard to find her sister, which she did.
Yes, yeah, she made it to the North Mountain, and that was... I'm a big fan.
Huge.
You get it?
I got it.
Yeah. Cool. It's cool. It's a pun. Sorry.
Anna was wondering if you've seen Elsa. We'd wanted to miss the Arendelle Festival.
Not that I remember.
No, I think we'd remember seeing the Queen of Arendelle.
Okay, well, do me a favor and keep an eye out for her, okay?
Okay, radio, Mr. Reindeer King.
It's just Kristoff.
Hey, where's Sven? We almost didn't recognize you without him.
Well, he found himself some carrots, but you know I couldn't help overhearing your story,
We couldn't help over-smelling you. Seriously, dude. People are gonna start to think that you are the reindeer. Do you know how to spell boy? Because B-O-Y.
Okay, you know, I did help Anna a lot. Without me, she would have never made it to the North Mountain.
Oh, besides, you like her!
Okay, now that had nothing to do with it. See, there was a blizzard. Uh-huh. With lots of ice everywhere.
Yeah.
And I sell ice. Yeah. So you see the problem?
Yeah.
Okay, so I had to help Anna to save my business.
Yeah, you just keep telling yourself that, Reindeer King. We know what's going on.
Okay, I have to get back to Anna.
Back to Anna?
And find Elsa.
Wait, Kristoff!
I wrote you a poem.
What?
Roses are red, violets are blue, you're hot.
All right!
Does that deserve applause? I don't... There you go. Yeah. Arya. She's a poet and she didn't even know it. Wow, that's great. You think he's dreamy and Hans is dreamy, and how come you never call me dreamy, huh?
Because you dress like an elf.
Don't laugh at that. Stop it, Arya. How could you say that? You know I have low elf esteem.
At Kristoff, start the long, cold journey up the North Mountain. They navigate dark woods where wolves attack their sled.
Werewolves!
Just wolves!
What? Regular wolves! And they lost Kristoff's newly lacquered sled in the process because
because the sled exploded, just like sleds do. So they walked.
They came across a beautiful glen with beautiful icicles and snow. It was so romantic.
And that is when the true hero of our story enters the picture.
Uh-oh.
An awesome talking snowman named
Olaf.
Like warm hugs in summer.
A snowman who loves the summertime. How can you not love this guy?
Summer. Oh, I don't know why, but I've always loved the idea of summer and sun and all things hot.
Really? I'm guessing you don't have much experience with heat.
Nope. But sometimes I like to close my eyes and imagine what it'd be like when summer dusk. Bees will buzz, kids will blow dandelion fuzz, and I'll be doing whatever snow does in summer. The hot and the cold are both so intense, put them together, it just makes sense. Put me in summer and I'll be a
puddle.
Happy snowman! When life gets rough, I like to hold on to my dream. Relaxing in the summer sun, just letting off steam. Oh, the sky. What frozen things do in summer?
I'm gonna tell him.
Don't you dare.
Voice. He loves the summertime. I love the summertime.
Summertime.
Eric, you're Eric.
I'm Eric. Oh, I'm Eric. I didn't read this part.
Me either.
Okay. Well, this is. Does anyone? Can someone just look this up? Okay, it's fine. Oh, Olaf saves the day.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Olaf stops Hans. He kicks him in the sideburns.
Yeah.
And he kisses Anna. Everybody lives happily ever after because
some people are worth melting for. The end.
The crowd goes wild.
That's great. Your Majesty! I'm so happy you're here. The royal historians, the Arendelle, have been sharing our story.
Well, thank you. And that was a very good story you told. Although the ending felt strange.
Olaf did help out a lot.
Anna, you saved your whole kingdom. You saved your sister and yourself.
An act of true love will thaw a frozen heart.
My sister, Elsa, I love you.
Excuse me, Queen Elsa. The citizens of the kingdom of Hollywood Land did an excellent job singing our Arendelle anthems.
You all look amazing in your face covering.
That's wonderful. You make all of Arendelle very proud.
Please come to the palace whenever you want. Gates are always open.
They will never close again. Yes, thank you, Eric. And you, Arya, the royal historians of Arendelle.
We are happy to be of service.
Elsa, today's the Arendelle Festival.
And I've got the perfect way to help celebrate.
Here, they're just letting it go, let it go, let it go. You know, kind of a song. You know how that song goes, don't you? And then Boo's sitting there getting snow all over him, and he's having a good old time singing along. Man, you should have heard him singing. But we had to cut out a lot of those, a lot of that clips because they copyrighted me. Oh well.
We love you!
We love you! Hey. I think the only new one on that stage was Anna. Anna was new. Everybody else we've seen before. We were so happy to see them. As you can hear, I was singing right along. It was just a fun time. I really missed my show. Didn't you? Did
mm-hmm.
you? Yeah. So we missed our show. So we're glad we're back. And this is where you can catch us every Monday. We'll be at one of these shows every Monday usually.
We might even be on the stage sometime.
You never know, we might be on the stage.
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna have to check it out to see if we're ever there.
Stay tuned.
Stay tuned for Yammy and Boo. Bye.
Subscribe, like, and hit that bell. Ring.
And come back and see Yammy some more.
Yeah.